Hello friends, in this video we are going to learn about volcanic activity and plate tectonics. What is the relation between volcanic activity and plate tectonics theory? Before this we have studied the basic theories of geology, and those were continental drift, sea floor spreading, plate tectonics theory and some other theories. So and we have also studied about volcanoes and volcanic activities, types of volcano and many other things. So now we are going to study what is the relation between volcanic activity and plate tectonics. So I have taught you everything. I have taught the plate tectonics theory, volcanoes also. Now we are going to see what is the relation between both of them. So according to the plate tectonics theory, there are three principal zones of volcanic activity. Means volcanic activity happen at three places. Okay, at three zones. The first is spreading centers that we studied in seafloor spreading. The ridges, the mid-oceanic ridges are basically the spreading centers where the crust spreads in both directions. Crust spreads laterally in both directions. In that we studied this spreading centers. Subduction zone, yeah, when the crust spreads, the place where the magma goes down or the convection current goes down. The crust also goes down, and crust goes down under another tectonic plate. I mean, one plate goes down under another tectonic plate. So that zone is called subduction zone. And regions with plates themselves, I mean, inside the plates somewhere volcanic activity takes place. So these are the three places where volcanic activity takes place. So before studying these three separately, we are going to study what is origin of magma, because some part of origin of magma will be used there. Okay, so we are going to study origin of magma. Okay, in origin of magma we just learned that there are three types of magma. The first one is basaltic magma. Okay, and the second one is andesitic magma, and the third one is rhyolitic magma. So now let us study these three deeply. Okay, in basaltic magma, SiO2, that is silicon dioxide, it is up to 45 to 55 in weight percent in the basaltic magma. Ferric FeMgCa, that is ferric, magnesium and calcium are high, and K, potassium and sodium, K means potassium and N means sodium, are low. Basaltic magma originate in asthenosphere at 200 kilometers depth, and it is lighter and has tendency to rise. Okay, so these are the features of basaltic magma. Next is andesitic magma. SiO2 is in the range 55 to 65 by weight percent, and FeMgCa are intermediate, and sodium and K and Na, that is potassium and sodium, are also intermediate. These are found by differentiation of basaltic magma. Differentiation is a very vast process. I will make another video on that topic, differentiation of magma. Okay, and close relation of andesitic magma with subduction zone indicates that it may have formed due to melting of lithosphere. Andesitic magma's relation with the subduction zone tells us that it is formed due to melting of lithosphere. The third type of magma is rhyolitic magma. In this, SiO2 is around 65 to 75 in weight percent. FeMgCa are low, and sodium and potassium are high. Okay, and this is formed due to remelting of continental crust. When continental crust is again remelted, then it is formed, and this erupt from volcano on continental crust. Okay, so these are the types of magma, origin of magma. Now moving ahead, now we are going to study those three in detail. The first one was spreading center, volcanic activity at spreading center. Greatest volcanic eruptions occur at mid-oceanic ridges. The spreading center are basically mid-oceanic ridges. And volcanic activity, when magma comes up, volcanic activity takes place. And where seafloor spreading is active, and when volcano comes up, so obviously seafloor spreads. At those places, volcanic eruptions take place. As lithosphere moves apart, basaltic magma rises from asthenosphere and fills the gap. As magma moves up. Magma rises from asthenosphere. It fills the gap. Gap means it creates a new crust, and that crust is joined with the older crust. And successive eruptions sometimes produce volcanic cone. And successive means continuous eruptions, one after the other, produce volcanic cones. So this was the first category. The second category is volcanic activity at subduction zone. So first I will tell you what is a subduction zone. This is the definition I have written here. The zone or the place where one plate moves under another